Namaskar and good afternoon. Welcome to our fourth episode of Digital Classes. It's me, Raju Gautam, and today I am here to teach of class 3, subject is science, and the unit name is, and the unit name is animals seen in different times and seasons. Again, listen very carefully. Animals seen in different times and seasons. My dear students, in the previous class, we have studied about the animals and their foods. So today we are going to study about the animals seen in different times and seasons. So let us start today from animals which are seen in different times and seasons. Now, basically we can observe that different type of animals, they can seen in different times and in different seasons. Almost all type of animals, they do not appear on the same season, but some of the animals they see during the summer season, some of the animals they see during the winter season, and some of the animals they see in the rainy season. So today let us discuss about some important features and important points regarding the animal seen in different times and seasons. So let us start. Point number A I have given here, animals seen in different times, according to the times. Times means what? Day and night. Day and night. Now, animals seen in different times. Now, dear students, you may have observed or you may have not observed, but listen very carefully and try to understand these things. It is very important, okay? Times. Those animals which we see during the daytime, it is not so that we are going to see that same animals at the night time also. Okay, so that's why animals seen in different times. We are discussing about this point. Now, again, animals which are seen at night time, we do not see in the daytime. Again, listen very carefully. The animals which are seen at the night time, they do not see at the daytime. So let us discuss now here. Point number one I have given here, A. Point number A, animals seen in different times. And here in point number A, there are two topics we are going to discuss about it. That is daytime animals. This one is daytime animals and another one is nighttime animals. Okay. Now, daytime animals. The animals which are active. Animals which are active during daytime are called diurnal animals. Again, listen very carefully, my dear students. The animals which are active during daytime are called diurnal animals. Okay, examples are cow, crow, and dog. Okay, cow, crow, and dog. Now, second one, nighttime. Okay, nighttime animals. The animals which are active during nighttime. Okay, animals which are active during nighttime are called nocturnal animals. Okay, now, nocturnal animals. The animals which are active during nighttime are called nocturnal animals. Now, examples are firefly, junkiri, it is called in Nepali, bat, chamera, fox, we see at the nighttime. Now, can you see firefly in the daytime? I don't think so. You don't see a firefly in the daytime. We cannot see a firefly in a daytime. Bat also we do not see in a daytime. Fox also we do not see in a daytime. They appear at nighttime. So that's why they are called what? Nocturnal animals. Okay. Now into point number B. Animals seen in different seasons. Again here. Animals seen in different seasons. Dear students, here, animals seen in different seasons. Okay, listen here. Animals seen in different seasons. Now here, summer season, rainy season, and winter season. Into three categories, we are dividing animals. Summer season, rainy season, and winter season. Some of the animals we can see during the summer season, and rainy season and winter season. Some of the common animals are seen only in summer season, Some of the common animals are seen only in rainy season, and some of the common animals are seen only in winter season. Okay, now regarding this one, it has got very different things. Okay, now like you, like me, okay, we are the animals which are called warm-blooded animals. Okay, later on we are going to, I'm going to describe about it, what are the warm-blooded animals, now what are their features. Now that one we are going to discuss later on. Now so let us discuss now about this one, animals seen in different seasons. Now summer season. Now dear students, do you really observe during the summer seasons what type of animals you see around your surrounding? Okay, if you have not observed it, observe it now. Okay, now it is very common to you and it is very common to us also. Okay, now summer season, what type of animals do we see during the summer season? Example, now during the summer seasons we see snakes. Again, in this same point I'm going to add another very important point, that winter season, during winter season, my dear students, we do not see snakes. Okay, this one you should remember that. Summer season, again I'm going to tell you, during the summer season we see snakes. Okay, now at present we see snakes, okay, around our surrounding, okay, around our locality or in the bushes or in the field. Okay, we see what, snakes. But at the same time I'm going to add another one here, winter season, during winter season, if you have observed that, we do not see snakes during the winter season. So that's why animals seen in different seasons, we see animals in different seasons. Now here, summer seasons. Summer seasons are very warm and hot type of seasons. Now during summer seasons, obviously dear students, you would have observed that rats, snakes, okay, snails, mosquitoes, housefly, and different type of insects, they are active during the summer season. Okay, rainy season, snail, okay, leech, and after that liver fluke, these type of animals are active during the rainy seasons. Okay, snails, that sankhe kira you call it in Nepali. Okay, now that one. Winter season, obviously during the winter seasons we do not see almost all type of animals, but some of the common types of animals are seen in our society or in our community. Okay, now summer season, rainy season, and winter season. I hope this one it is clear regarding to you, animals seen in different seasons. Now let us come to here, next topic. Here it is, I have given one definition regarding the hibernation, very important point. Okay, now this one is very important definition, my dear students, very important. This one is a very long deep sleep of some animals during winter season is called hibernation. A very long deep sleep, okay, a very long sleep during the summer season, sorry, during the winter season of some animals are called hibernation. That means they go for a long winter sleep. They sleep for 3 or 4 or 5 months. Okay, now obviously they are going to sleep for 4 months. Now I have said here summer seasons, animals which are seen in the summer seasons. Now here, as I have said here, we have discussed here different seasons. Now summer seasons, here hibernation, what are animals they go for a hibernation? Those animals which are active during the summer season and they are passive during the winter season. So that means they are going for a long winter sleep during the winter season. Okay, now that's why this definition is, it is a very important definition. A very long deep sleep of some animals during winter season is called hibernation. Okay, now it's called a hibernation. This is very important definition. Now snakes, lizards, okay, fox, and after that insects, any type of insects it may be, whatever it may be, ant, okay, camilla example, we see it only during the summer season, but in the winter season we do not see ant, any type of ant. Insects also we do not see, almost all type of insects we do not see during the winter season, except spiders. Okay, they live in a web inside our rooms, so that's why, except spiders, other animals we do not see. Lizard we do not see during the winter season. Okay, so that is the exact definition of a hibernation. A very long deep sleep of some animals during winter season is called hibernation. Again, this hibernation definition is attached with other definitions here. This one, cold-blooded animals. Now animals are categorized in two groups here, okay, in class 3, okay, in grade 3 we are going to learn about it. cold-blooded animals and warm-blooded animals. Okay, now here cold-blooded animals, those animals which cannot control their body temperature and become inactive are called cold-blooded animals. Again, listen very carefully. Cold-blooded animals, those animals which cannot control their body temperature, they do not have any control on their body temperature and become inactive means they are not active, are called cold-blooded animals. Okay, now are called cold-blooded animals. Now examples here, very simple example: snake, frog, lizard. As I have said here in the definition of hibernation, snake, frog and lizard, they go for a long winter sleep. That is a definition of hibernation. So cold-blooded animals, they go for a long winter sleep. That is a hibernation. Okay, now next one, very important point here regarding the warm-blooded animals. Now those animals that maintain a constant body temperature. Okay, now those animals that maintain a constant body temperature in any case means whatever the condition it may be, like you and like me. Okay, during winter season also we feel cold. Obviously we are going to feel cold, but what do? We protect ourselves by putting on warm clothes. In these same conditions, animals they could not put on warm clothes, so that's why they go for a long winter sleep. Again, that is called a hibernation. But here we are discussing about warm-blooded animals, those animals that maintain a constant body temperature. Constant body temperature in any cases, whether it is cold, hot, rainy, okay, warm, we are remaining a constant body temperature. We remain in a constant body temperature are called warm-blooded animals. Examples: dog, cat, cow, me, you, staying at home. Okay, we are warm-blooded animals. Okay, now we are warm-blooded animals. Now sorry, now here next one, examples here: dog, cat, cow, you and me. These are the certain basic things regarding animals seen in different times and seasons. Okay, my dear students, animals seen in different times and seasons, these are the basic things and very important things for the lesson animals seen in different times and seasons. Now I hope you are very much clear regarding animals seen in different times. Times means day and night. Okay, secondly, I hope you are very clear regarding the animals seen in different seasons. Animals seen in different seasons. Now here, summer season, rainy season and winter season. Okay, now some of the animals, they are very much active during the summer season and rainy season, and they disappear during the winter season. Okay, now these are the common things regarding the animals seen in different times and seasons. Okay, I hope, my dear students, only this much for today. Okay, so see you next time in the next episode of our digital classes. So until then, be safe, stay at home, and please do regular home assignment as I am going to provide you in the page of Bishwati. Namaskar.